2022 marks the 50th anniversary of BMW's famed M division, and they're celebrating in many ways. One of the ways in which they're celebrating is with this. This is the 2022 BMW X3 M Competition. Let's go for a drive. I'm your host, Brian Max, racing driver, lover of driving fast, fun things. And on this channel, you get reviews for drivers from drivers. Now, if you're a regular viewer, you know I'm not a fan of the competition name on any BMW road car because you can't really race them. They do actually sell competition cars, but the road cars aren't those. Nonetheless, I'm glad that BMW M has gotten serious again. And for this 50th anniversary, they have made this X3 M competition a little bit faster, certainly a little stiffer, as you can see on this rough road. But nonetheless, before we get into what it's like to drive, let's have a look at this X3 M competition in a little more depth. Yes, this is the X3 M competition, and we can debate whether or not something like this needs a competition badge because I don't think we're going racing with this. But nonetheless, BMW's M division goes through this and touches almost every single aspect of the X3 to make it deserving of the M badge. And most importantly, it's got a lot more power. The S58 3-liter inline 6 makes 503 horsepower at 6250 RPM and 439 pounds of torque from 2750 to 5500 RPM. The 8-speed automatic is tuned by M, as is the all-wheel drive, and it's got an E-diff in the back. And before we talk about the suspension, I have to mention that there's a lot of chassis bracing that goes into this X3 M. Suspension uses adaptive dampers, as you'd expect. Steering is variable ratio, variable assist, and it is M-tuned as well. This one has the M compound brakes, and that means it's got 4 piston calipers at the front with 395 millimeter rotors, single piston calipers at the rear with 370 millimeter rotors. This one's rocking the 21 inch wheels and tires. Two things: these wheels are lighter than the others, and these are non-run flat tires, which is the way to go. Of course, curb weight of this X3 M competition is not a lightweight 4,600 pounds, but weight distribution is 50-50. But on this channel, we know it's not static weight distribution that counts, it's how you use it. Sorry for this brief interruption, but I want the opinion of regular viewers of the show. I'm now co-hosting a radio show Saturday mornings in Toronto. It's called Dave's Corner Garage. Go to davescornergarage.com. Links here, links below, and listen in on Saturdays. Podcast episodes are on the website as well, and I'd love to know what you think. So go to davescornergarage.com. Listen in Saturday mornings, 10 a.m. in Toronto. All the details are there, and let me know what you think in the comments below. Much appreciated. Thank you. Thankfully, BMW is still building cars for drivers, and this is no exception. And you know, even their EVs are pretty good for drivers like us. But what I really dig about this is that the cockpit is perfectly sorted. I've got a great interface to this X3 M, great steering wheel, decent seating position. I'd like to get a little bit lower, but wonderful seat. This seat is highly adjustable, very, very supportive, and great on long distances. It's just perfection, except I'd like to get a little bit lower. Otherwise, if you're familiar with modern BMWs, you're gonna be right at home here. All of the ergonomics are simple, straightforward, and definitely oriented to the driver. This is the X3 M, so we've got great visibility in all directions. And of course, this has cameras and sensors and all that stuff to help you park. Plus, this X3 is the right size. It's very maneuverable. I find the X5 just to be a little bit too big for my liking, certainly too big for an urban environment in which I drive. I really dig this X3 size, both inside and out. Speaking of the inside, it's very spacious here. I've got more than enough room behind my seating position just to sit there and be comfortable. There's lots of room under the hatch. You and your passenger are going to be very comfortable here, and there's a decent amount of storage in this front row as well, and tons of cargo space. The infotainment system is not exactly BMW's latest if we include their EVs. Their EVs are kind of cutting edge, but this is not bad. It's kind of what I dig, and on top of that, it's got Apple CarPlay, so it works wonderfully for me. I just rely on on CarPlay for all of my driving needs. I have no idea if it has Android Auto. Maybe some of you know, but I really don't care. You'd think something with the competition badge should be about performance, and it kind of is. It's definitely about acceleration. It'll do 0 to 60 in the mid threes. They say 3.7, but I think in perfect conditions, it's much, much quicker than that. Governed, this will do 155 miles an hour. Uncorked, it'll do about 177 miles an hour. That would be interesting in terms of aerodynamics at that speed, but thankfully, in this part of the world, we don't have the unlimited speeds of the Autobahn. Nonetheless, this S58, the way it's tuned, it's just a torque monster. It makes maximum torque everywhere in the rev range. In normal driving, you've got peak torque just the tip of the throttle away. So what that does for you and your passengers is it makes for a little bit more of a relaxed driving experience because the gearbox is not busy. You can hang on to taller gears and it just makes maximum torque. Like, we're just cruising up this hill. I think we're in sixth gear and no trouble at all accelerating up this hill. You'd think so with all the power and all the torque that this thing makes. And then on top of that, it kind of rewards you if you get into this thing. It makes maximum power just about at red line. So that is very, very cool. It rewards you with maximum power if you take it all the way up to red line. Very, very interesting in that regard. And it's kind of cool that they put an engine like this in an SUV like this. The gearbox is programmed to drive in a manner that suits all the drive modes, suits the way you drive, so you can drive it a little bit more relaxed. And then when you hustle this thing, it shifts quick and does rev match downshifts as well. And when you are in the more extreme drive modes, the shifts are very quick and the gearbox is responsive. You got the shift paddles here, and you can set this up to shift manually in one of the M modes. I've got my M modes configured a little bit differently, but both of them are set with soft dampers, which we will get into a little bit later. For the longest time, when M has been able to tweak the xDrive systems in some of their all-wheel drive cars, what they do is they give it a little bit more of a rearward bias, and that's evident here. It is evident that it is all-wheel drive, but there's a little bit more of a rearward torque bias to this thing, so it's very much a driver's car. It responds like a driver's car, and that's the way it should be. When you get onto the power, you want to be pushing this thing with the rear wheels and let those front wheels do a little bit of the steering, less of the power distribution to the ground. That'll overtax the front tires a little bit, and that's why they do these things with M cars. Plus, this thing has the E-diff. I think they call it the M active differential. What that means, it's an electronically controlled limited slip diff, so it's completely variable in terms of lock, and then under braking, it's open, so it's more stable, and that is helpful. Gives you more confidence under braking, but also makes the braking slightly more efficient. But for me, I like to be able to brake confidently, and that's one of the cool byproducts of an E-diff, and I love the way BMW does those. They are not intrusive at all, and I've never found BMW's E-diffs to put a foot wrong anywhere. On top of all that, as you'd expect for a 2022 model, it does have some advanced driver assist, which I like, especially in a busy urban environment like mine. Works very well. Love how BMW sets up theirs. Now, in terms of actual driving, well, here's the thing. Even though that this is an SUV with a taller center of gravity and weighs a fair bit, it's still very responsive. In terms of steering response, it's quite good, and that has to do with M tweaking this steering system. It is variable ratio and variable assist. So at lower speeds, the ratio is a little bit quicker so that it's a little bit more responsive, and at highway speeds and above, it's a little bit slower so that you don't get yourself into trouble and you don't really want that quick kind of steering in a road car at high speeds. So really well done, BMW. As responsive as the steering is, you're not getting a lot of feel or feedback through the steering wheel from those contact patches, so you're probably gonna have to rely more on your eyes and some chassis feel, but otherwise it works quite well. Now, what is excellent is the feel you get from these M compound brakes. I am seriously impressed with these brakes. These are high performance sports car level brakes. I've got tremendous confidence to place this car on a dime with the brake pedal. It's absolutely one of the features that I love about this X3 M Comp. As you'd expect from a high performance SUV, it should be satisfying to throw around in the corners. And indeed it is. When the roads are smooth like this, it is just wonderful, absolutely satisfying to drive. And I mean, this thing is quick. It rockets out of corners. It handles beautifully. Body and wheel control is just top notch. So the tires, contact patches are always in contact with the road. Does an excellent job in terms of the overall suspension setup. However, we live in a place where there are some crappy roads. And what that means is it highlights some deficiencies in some performance car setups. And this is a performance SUV, so it does have an overall bias towards outright handling than comfort. So it's stiffly sprung, stiffly damped, even in comfort mode. So I'm running the dampers in comfort mode, the softest mode possible, so that I've got the softest ride, because our roads are just terrible here. And when we do encounter those roads here, that wasn't too bad, but some of our roads are just awful. And what that does is it bounces you around a little bit. I don't think some passengers would complain, but on longer distances, especially when the roads are rough, this would get a little annoying. But for me, it's an excellent trade-off given the performance capabilities of this X3M Comp. And somehow they've been able to limit body roll with this tall, heavy SUV. It definitely suits the character of this. And there's very limited body roll. There's just enough to let you know what's going on here, but it's very well controlled. And overall, it's got an incredible dynamic package. The way it's able to put down power, the traction that it's got, and it's got a complete handling package that suits the nature of a high-performance SUV. How do you spec yours? Well, there are some considerations, especially for my American friends. Base price of one of these X3 M competitions is about $73,000 US, or in Canada, it's $94,000. As tested with some options, this is about $86,000 US, or $106,000 Canadian. As for my American friends, well, to the best of my knowledge, you cannot get this urban green paint. Yes, it's very fashionable. Yes, it's very much of the time, but if you're keeping this for a couple of years, this is a very cool color to be rocking, that's for sure. I would go with black or a metallic black, and you guys probably know that already. As for those considerations, well, the X3 M Competition is relatively well equipped with all the good stuff. So for example, this one has the 21s with the non-run flats, which is very important because they are Michelins and they are lovely. And this has the M compound brakes, which have greater thermal capacity than those of the X3M. So this is the kind of stuff that you want, and it's appropriate for a go fast SUV like this. Otherwise, I think you want to consider the M driver's package, I think it's called. One of the things it does come with, or doesn't come with, is the speed limiter. Normally this is limited to 155 miles an hour, which I think this one is, but without it, it'll do 177 miles an hour. Great if you're taking your X3M competition on the Autobahn. My verdict? Well, let's start with fuel consumption, only because I actually paid attention, and I'm getting about 19.5 miles per gallon, or 12 liters per 100 kilometers for my Canadian friends. And for me, that's exceptional. I would have thought I would have been doing much worse. I guess some of the tuning that's gone into this engine has made it a little bit more efficient, because I shouldn't be able to get this kind of mileage given the way I drive this thing. Nonetheless, I think there are some considerations. This X3 M Competition is on the firm side. If you're looking for something a little softer and maybe a better value, you might want to look at the X3 M 40. But this, as it stands, this X3 M Competition is probably the best all-around performance SUV that you can buy today. It's quick, it's responsive, it does everything a driver expects it to do, and on top of that, it's satisfying to drive. So if you're looking at an SUV, that's got a whole lot of performance and that does everything right. It's the right size, it's the right form factor, it'll haul your family, it'll haul your cargo, and it'll go very, very quickly. You can't go wrong if you look at this X3 M Competition. Thanks for hanging out with me today and having a look at this 2022 BMW X3 M Competition, celebrating 50 years of BMW's M division. Hope you liked this episode, and if you did, well, you're not new to YouTube, you know what to do. Smash the subscribe button, turn on your notifications, like this video, and as always, sharing is caring. So please share this with your friends, especially on Reddit, because on Reddit, they really need to see reviews for drivers from drivers. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comments below, and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. If you want to support the channel, please hit up our new merch store. Lots of great stuff for driving enthusiasts like us, including our very popular line of Save the Manuals merch, and there's lots of new stuff there too, so go check it out. Links here, links below. Thanks again for watching. We'll see you again next time, and remember, cars don't understeer by themselves, not even BMW high-performance SUVs.